Welcome to this video and to this collaboration organized by Bea Grob. And playing along, Gina Bronzini and Chelsea Paper Ocotillo and your friend Martha from Ayala Art. So, this collaboration is to make a spring theme painting or collage, and then we exchange digitally the creations and make a new painting or page or ATC, whatever each person can. And on this occasion, I am going to be working on my art journal, on this sketchbook, if you will. So I'm trying to finish the journal, and I am going to be working with this collaging on the page, probably a dress and a hat and something else. This is the one I made, and my friends are going to be working with this. I decided not to use it on this page in particular, but it will come up in the next one. And if you want to see how I made this, stay all the way to the end, where I'm going to be linking a different video to show you the how-to. Welcome to the Ayala Art I Love to Paint channel. This is your artsy friend Martha. If you are art inclined, love art journaling, acrylic painting, and mixed media, this is your channel. Now, as for this, I am going to be probably, let's see, I can probably make, I'm thinking, a flower with these beautiful colors on a hat and her dress. First, however, I'm going to quickly paint her face. I'm going to be using this vintage white and probably my Neocolor 2 in this, which one is this? This is ochre. And maybe a little bit of purple for the face. Okay, I will have my brushes ready and work. And since many of us all around the world will have some extra time, either because we decided or because we were pushed to stay home, I hope you stay calm and you stay happy painting. I have a bunch of playlists that you can watch while avoiding social events and all of those things. If you're enjoying this video and love painting, consider subscribing and click on the bell to get notified of all the new videos. Well, I noticed that my nose is a little bit more to this side. If it becomes too important for you to be completely centered, you can adjust just by kind of moving things a little bit, either the eye, which would be easier to stretch this way, or to move the nose, but that would imply that you have to kind of move also the mouth and all of those other things. I'm just going to kind of move the eye a bit and be happy with the results, because I am not going to just fret too much about it. I'm going to add a little bit of color just to make this more noticeable. I'm going to wait for this to dry, and then I will think of what to do for the hair. Probably black, so it pops more, or dark brown, and then I will start the collage. So, see you in a minute. I'm going to cut this out like a flower, and then I'm going to add it on this side, I think. Yeah, somewhere in there. I like it with this other coloring here. So let's see what happens. And after that, or maybe I can make it a little smaller, shorter this way, like this. Okay, so first I'm going to do the dress part and then the hair, because the hair is going to come on top. It's going to go over here on top. And I need my little cover for the back pages. Since this is printer paper, I started from the back in the hopes that I'm not going to drag too much or squash too much the paper and then disfigure it or something. Because it's fragile as opposed to have it like a collage paper that is stronger. So I like to start with the medium in the back of the paper and press gently. If it was strong paper, you can do whatever you want, or if you don't care, like when I use napkins, if you don't care what happens to the texture of the napkin, you can just pretty much do whatever you want, since it is for texture. But at this point, I want it not torn, just well attached to the painting, but gently, right? And then I had these other little parts. Somewhere in here. These are just because I ended up with not a lot of detail in this part. It had a few white areas, but I love the green and the blue, and I think it's going to turn out really, really cute. So I'm going to do the flower as well, and then the hair. So that was a little bit of a change of direction, not a big deal, but I wanted to make sure that I will have this and then the hair. We don't want bubbles, so we have to go slowly pushing this, gently too, because the last thing we need is a torn spot in there in the flower. Anyway, this is done at this part over here, at this point. I'm going to make sure that I'm not gluing the other page under. And I'm going to let it dry just enough so I can go back with my charcoal pencil and start marking some parts. I probably could do this while it's wet. Either way is fine. Just remember that after you finish rolling the chalk pencil or any other type of pencil on top of wet medium, you're going to have to kind of clean it. Well, not kind of, you definitely need to clean it. It's going to be really how can you say it, stuck with the acrylic, like a cap on top of it, and it's not going to paint or draw. So you need to either dry it or wait until it's wet so you can clean it. All right, now it's going to dry. If you are enjoying this video and love painting, subscribe and click on the bell to get notified of all the new videos. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share it if you like it, leave a comment, I love to hear from you, and also check shortly on how this pretty spring painting got done. And more than anything else, remember to keep your paintbrush wet.